I welcome you all today to ECTVN Marriages Today. My name is Sister Rashida Florence Conte. Here with me in the studio, we have Pastor Josephine Olatunde from Revelation Praise Prayer Tower Ministry. Pastor, we welcome you. Thank you for being in the studio with us today.
It's a pleasure for having me. Thank you.
Praise God. Today in the studio, we'll be talking about several topics about marriages. One of the topics we'll be talking about is the ideal Christian spouse. My question to you, Pastor, what is the criteria for someone who's looking for a Christian spouse?
Very good. This is one of the topics that I always love to deal with as a marriage therapist and as a marriage counselor. Marriage in our days has been ordained by God. It's one of the greatest gifts to mankind. For a man to actually leave his father's house and join with his wife so that the two can become one. Steps to go into choosing a partner, I mean, not a temporary partner, but a life partner, is first the golden rule. It's to seek the face of God. You need to seek the face of God. The word of God tells us in Matthew 6:33 that when we seek first the kingdom of God, all other things will be added unto it. You need to seek the face of God. What is God telling you? What are the plans of God in your life? You know that God has the best in store for you. When you seek the face of the Lord, you present the quality that you want to see in your spouse. Something that admires you, something that attracts you, something that you see that you visualize. In order for you to have this life partner, do not take marriage as a joke. Trust me, do not take it as a joke, but you need to be diligent. You need to be able to stand your ground. Pray to God fervently. You need to pray to God. Let God order your steps. And you need to know the kind of qualities you need to see in your husband to be or your wife to be. First and foremost, take it before the Lord in prayer. Let the Lord direct your step. Let him order your steps. You need to look at yourself that would you want to spend your life, your entire future with this person? It's something that has to come within you. And you need to be able to bring this person to your world. You need to be able to accept this person. So the most important steps is for you to pray. Look at your qualities, the qualities that you want to see in your spouse, present it before the Lord and let the Lord order your steps because the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord.
Praise the God.
Amen.
Now, my next question will be, you know, based on what you said, it brought me to this great question. Bible said in 2 Corinthians 6:14 that let us not be yoked with unbelievers. But the Bible also let us believe that as a child of God, you must love your neighbor just as you love yourself. Anyone who comes to the house of God is coming for refuge and for support. But yet in the same house of God, there are many people that come in. They're wearing sheep clothing, but yet underneath they're wolves. Because they believe in the house of God, that's where they can find the perfect spouse. As a child of God in the church, how do you detect those wolves that are coming in sheep clothing? How do you separate yourself and how do you accept this wolf that you have found and to regenerate their life to become that ideal Christian spouse?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You actually said it. We cannot be an unequally yoke, according to his word in 2 Corinthians 6:14, with an unbeliever. In order for you to know the right person for you, God is a faithful God. Seek God and he will direct you. You need to be able to know what you want in a man and in a woman. You have to have that mind that this is your vision. You want your woman to be God-fearing. You want your wife to be God-fearing. You want your husband to be God-fearing. If I take you back to Proverbs chapter 18, verse 22, it says that whoever finds a wife or finds a woman finds a good thing and obtaineth favor from the Lord. How do you find a good thing? By seeking God, because he knows the intent of your heart. He knows what is best for you. He knows the thoughts that he has towards you. You can't choose by yourself. You can't choose for yourself. You let God choose for you. Well, a lot of people might be attracted to a very beautiful woman outwardly, but deep down, is the woman beautiful inwardly? Many people are attracted to a man because of their riches, of their fame, or their education. But what is God telling you? Seek God first. Is this the right man for me? Is this the right woman for me? Is this the person that the Lord wants me to spend my entire future with? It's not everything that glitters, it's gold. But we must be able to obtain that wisdom. Wisdom comes from God. Tell the Lord this hour, Lord, direct my steps for that ideal partner. Many people are in the church. It's true. They're just churchgoers. They're not really regenerated. How do you differentiate between the churchgoers and the regenerated believers? By still seeking the face of the Lord. Let the Lord minister to you. That is why he left us with the greatest comforter, the Holy Spirit, who teaches us the good and the bad and the ugly. Let God be God in your life today and let him decide. Let him direct you. Let him order your steps and let him be able to show you too, so that you can discern who your bright partner should be. God bless.
Praise God. That was an awesome, wonderful response. And I know our viewers today will be searching their hearts and just pondering on some of those great Bible verses that you have given unto them. This brings me to my final question. Many people get married because of age. They feel like they are 40, so they should get married. Some people get married because of they already have children with this person, so they don't want to go start a new family. They rather just marry that person. And others just get married because of social stigmatism. Now, as a believer, what are the good ways to consider, despite all of this fluctuating around you, what are the good ways to consider making this lifetime decision? Over to you, Pastor.
Thank you. Very good. One thing I want us to realize is that all things work together for good, for those who love the Lord and for those that are called according to God's purpose in Romans 8. One thing you must also realize today is that you do not rush to get married. You need to take a step back and let God steps into your life. Well, it's all said that people get married for various reasons, but as a true child of God, what are your factors of you getting married? What do you want to see in a marriage? What do you want to have in a marriage? Of course, we all know that time waits for nobody, and any opportunity that is lost, it takes the grace of God to bring those opportunities back. But I want you to tell you today, I want to encourage you, don't reason like the world reasons. Don't think like the world. Think like kingdom-minded. Seek God. Because Ecclesiastes chapter 3 says that us in 11 to 13, it makes all things beautiful in his own time. If we look at the story of Isaac, Isaac was not a young man when he got married. He got married at the age of 40 years old. When Abraham sent his servants to go and fetch his son a wife, he had a plan. He knew what he wants for Isaac. And he told him, he said, listen, this is the quality that I'm looking for my wife. What is the quality are you looking for in your own spouse today? Don't look at what the time is saying, but look at the appointed time of God for your life, because it can never be too late for a Christian. Age must not be a barrier. Nothing must be a stumbling block, because as long as you remain in the kingdom, God has a purpose and a special plan for your life. And I do not want you to feel as if nothing is going to work for you. Because when man thinks everything, it's all said and done, that is when our Creator comes in and steps in and he turns things around. So for you to know who your ideal spouse is, trust also in God always. Many a times we trust in our armor flesh, but armor flesh will fail us. But when you put your trust in the Lord, when you put your confidence in the Lord, he will bring it to pass in your life. And you will have every reason to glorify the living God. God bless you.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, woman of God. That was a wonderful message. That was a great message to everyone that is listening out there today. I thank each and every one of our viewers today that you have taken this time out to listen. And those words will continue to digest in your mind, in your soul. I thank every one of you far and near that is watching. I pray that God will help you locate that spiritual Christian spouse that you are searching for. That individual that will become a blessing unto the generation. Once again, I say thank you all for viewing with us at ECTV. God bless you. My name again, Sister Rashida Florence Conte. And once again, I want to thank the pastor for being here with us.
Thank you.
God bless you, ma'am. God keep you. God strengthen you. Once again, we say thank you and have a wonderful day.
ECTVN, the station that inspires.